With the 3.11 software release, you get support for ARM's serial wire debug interface, known as SWD, libraries for your own XJEase files, and a new clock generator. If you're using a processor, an SoC, or another device with a Cortex core, you can benefit from the SWD protocol support that's been added to the XJLink 2. Any two pins can now be configured to become an SWD interface. Not only does it allow an SWD device's internal memory to be programmed straight from the XJLink 2, but it also provides a way to directly control the device during a board test. That means the interface can be used to program external memories and to interact with peripherals such as ADCs. All of this improves your test coverage. There's also support for ICs that multiplex SWD onto their JTAG pins. A new feature gives you automatic switching between the two modes. With all JTAG devices, bringing out the full set of JTAG signals is always the thing to do for best test coverage, but occasionally that's just not possible. In those situations, you can now check the connections of an SWD device by manipulating its GPIO pins over the bus. With more and more ICs using SWD, we think you'll find the support for this interface a really useful feature. Something else that comes with this release is an application that enables you to create and manage your own library of XJEase device files and circuit code files. It's a great way to keep track of the files you've written or edited. It also syntax checks your files, allows changes to be documented, and detects if you're using an old file version and offers to update it for you. And if you've got multiple users in your company, you can maintain that library centrally and distribute it around your organization. That can help drive consistency between teams, reduce the risk of duplicating work, and minimize the time needed to maintain projects. When you're using XJ Developer, simply add the new library to the list of libraries being used. When it comes to importing a BOM file into your project, it used to be that you needed a CSV or text file. Now though, in response to some engineering requests, we've added support for importing BOM files in Excel format, including those with multiple tabs. It might seem small, but it can simplify creating projects. And now here's something a bit different. If you need a way to stop a watchdog resetting your board during a test, or you just want a simple clock input, then you could well benefit from XJLink 2's new oscillator. It comes with XJTAG 3.11 and gives you not just convenience, but potentially also cost savings, because in many instances, you'll no longer need a separate signal generator. It's flexible and easy to use, and you can adjust it between 10 kHz and 160 MHz in 10 kHz steps. When it's switched off, its output becomes high impedance. The XJEase language makes it easy to use in a test, and because it runs without continuous software interaction, it's ideal for testing a board that requires a constant input. It's available on all XJLink 2 based hardware, including the USB, PXI, and quad versions. Thinking about log files now, we've made it easier for you to find the one file you're looking for out of your whole collection. The log file viewer can now search and filter a set of log files based on their individual contents. You'll no longer need to open them all separately to locate the ones you're after. For example, you can now filter log files to find those where a particular test failed, or those generated in a particular time period, or from a specific XJPack or XJTAG version. That makes it quicker to identify trends or debug problems. And when it comes to looking at individual files, you can now preview the list of tests in that file and their results before opening it to make sure you've got the right one. Once you have opened it, there's also simplified navigation through the file. When you select a particular test from the navigation pane, the relevant section in the text will now be briefly highlighted. We also added a most recently used list of folders. It all simplifies working with log files. And finally, if you use dynamic JTAG chains, you might like to know it's now easier to switch between profiles in the analyzer, debug connection test, and pin mapping screens. You don't need to change the project's default setting anymore, but you can now switch freely between the profiles in all relevant screens. So, all in all, there are quite a few helpful changes in this latest XJTAG release. If you've got a valid support contract, you can download XJTAG 3.11 from our website. Otherwise, contact us at enquiries@xjtag.com or find out more from xjtag.com.